worry about things. I was no longer bitter. I was no longer resentful. I was no longer envious. I was no longer jealous. All of the above, the depression, anxiety, the devil brain, that perverse demon that was over my life, he revealed himself to me. There was a demon of perverse, and that's why we had so much infidelity and promiscuous in our relationship. And so after he revealed himself, you know, after I was spending so much time, I was getting cleansed. Yes. The Lord was cleansing me. And then all of a sudden, I had all this grace in my life.
Yes.
I had all this grace in my life, like 360, turn around, all of a sudden, this happy person. All of a sudden, I'm so bold, I'm so courageous, I'm praying for people, I'm doing stuff in and out of the church that I was at the time. I was in a home, we were in a home, like a more intimate church. And so, you know, I was just being transformed like that. People in my family, they just thought like, oh my goodness, Christina's such a bee. Like, she's so evil, she's so hateful, she's just ugly. Like, no one wanted to be around me. No one wanted to be around me. Like, you wouldn't want to be my friend. You didn't want to get me mad. You didn't want to catch me on a bad day. My husband knows that. Like, I would have made it hell for you. And it's just so crazy. And it's like, from day and night, from the next day, when I heard the Lord's voice, to just be transformed that quickly. But it was putting the time in and spending time with him, how I received the abundance of grace.
Yes.
And you know, some of us right now are going through so many trials and so many hardships. Some of us need healing. Some of us just need a wake-up call from God. And I feel like we're putting too much on the enemy and what the devil's trying to do to us, and we're forgetting about what God has in store for us in our life. He's made us to be whole. He's made us to look like him. He's made us to walk like him. He's made us to walk in love like him. He's made us for others, not for ourselves. Yes. He made us for his kingdom and to see people through his kingdom, not to see them with their problems and their issue. Amen. Look past the problem and see their potential. Yes. See people as God sees them.
Amen.
God didn't make us to see that way. And like, so many of us were like complaining over someone who cut us off. We're complaining because we didn't get the best parking. That was me. I was mad because I couldn't get the best parking. Like, I was mad because someone cut in front of me at the grocery store. And then I was pissed, like, this person mad. And I was so mad. I was so mad. And it's crazy how we're so self-involved. We're so self-emotional when we weren't made for ourselves. We're made for others. We're made for the kingdom of God. We're made to look like God.
Yes, amen.
So I want to explain to you, and I want to teach you, how do we receive the abundance of grace? How did grace come into my life so strongly? How was I so quickly transformed? And if you guys open up to Romans 5:17, we can go from there.
Ready.
Yes, right? Okay, so it's just what I left off on, how so many people need God. We need God right now, and for whether it's healing your anxiety, or it's a personal problem at work, a co-worker, whatever, we need God. But I feel like we're just meeting the problem and then we're running to the gospel hoping that it's working. And it doesn't work like that. Grace is there for those who receive it. So we're going to go ahead and read this verse, and I'm going to go ahead and give an example of how you receive the abundance of grace and how it properly works. Okay, so verse 17, Romans 5, for it, because of one man's trespasses, death reigned through that one man, Adam, it's speaking about. Much more will those who receive an abundance of grace and be free, and the free gift of righteousness reign in the life through one man, Jesus Christ. Notice that it says, those who receive the abundance of grace. Now let me just demonstrate, how do you receive the abundance of grace? You wake up, thank you, Lord, that you created me a new day. The old is gone, and behold, it is new. Thank you, Lord, that you are so towards me that I lack nothing. Everything that I need to be molded into you is already with me and in me. Your light is upon me. You direct my eyes, my ears, and my hand. Your grace is sufficient for me. You created me as your daughters and your son. You created me into your sonship, into your priesthood. Thank you, Lord, that I can live as your daughter and I can be in your family of God. That's how you receive, and that's how you receive the abundance of grace. But all you did is you waked up and you started believing. You woke up and you started believing. So now when you go ahead and hit a trial, the Holy Spirit is ready. and it's there to defend you. You don't hit a trial and now you're running to the Word and hoping that it works. That makes no sense, and that's no faith. You have a problem and now you're like, oh, holy is the Lamb, let me pray for grace, God, over my life, and then you see no results. People, we're all taught to run to God when there's an issue. We run to God, oh God, like, please, if I'm pregnant, like, oh my goodness, I worship you every single day of my life. You know, if I'm just not pregnant, or like whatever you're going through as a young person or whatever, you know, like we hit the issue and then we want to run to God. We want to make an urgency to God. But why aren't we waking up and stressing that God should be first in our life in the first place? Why aren't we doing that? Why aren't we waking up and just being grateful for His graciousness? He is a gracious God. That means He's a favorable God. He wants to give you favor. He's so gracious.
Amen.
He's waiting for you to come at Him so He can say, here, my daughter, here's what you need. But why are we making no urgency to Him? We're going up about our day with our snobby faces, and we're mad that we didn't get the right parking. And then the issue hits, then you want to go to the Word, and then you want to see if it works. No, you wake up and you believe it.
Amen.
And the abundance of grace will be there for you. And that's how my life got transformed. I woke up every day believing the 3 hours a day of what I was reading. I believed it and I took it to heart. His Word will never fail. I had nothing else. Honestly, I couldn't rely on my husband, like I said. I was looking for the answers everywhere. Obviously, He wasn't doing it for me. God was the only answer. So me spending time in that Word, then I had to trust. This is the answer. So I woke up every day putting His Word upon my life, speaking His promises upon my life every single day.
Amen.
And by the time I knew it, repentance was there. I was transformed.
Amen.
I was transformed. And here I am today, 2 years old,
yes,
with such wisdom, with such, yes, knowledge. And I don't, yes, mean that to be cocky. I'm saying that for the glory of God.
Yes.
Why, church, all of you who've been Christians for 20, 30 years, how come you haven't been here in this right here? You all have something to give.
Yes.
But we're waiting to take. You shouldn't be waiting to take. We were made in the image of God. We're called to know Him. We're called to be like Him.
Right.
Amen.
Oh my gosh. Like, I'm sorry for my passion, but I get aggressive. But we should all have aggressive faith. We shouldn't just be like, oh, I'm waiting for grace to hit my life. No. Read your Word, and it goes to show that so many people that I minister to, so many people that I meet along the way, they want to say that they're Christians, but they're not reading the Word. This is your sword. This is, I'm ready for battle. This is why I can conduct myself in such a manner. My husband pisses me off. But you know what? I could yell and scream and rant and rave, but no, I conduct myself in a manner which God would want me to walk by the Spirit. I give it up to God. I cast my cares. And you know what? I believe in His promises. If I have faith in God, then I have faith in my husband. And you know what? He comes and He defends our relationship every single time. The abundance of grace is always there. Always there. Because I wake up and I just believe. It's faith. It's putting in the time. I have faith and trust. The grace is there. The authority is there. So now that's how I receive the abundance of grace. I swear, it's so simple. It's so simple. Just give God the time. So now I want to go into the second thing is of our calling. So now it's our calling. I feel like this goes hand in hand because I transformed and now I know my calling because of the abundance of grace. So I feel like this is going hand in hand for my quick short testimony. So let me just get into it and then we can go through verses, or I can just call them out. You guys can look at it later. So after, as I transformed, you know, I start reading and I start hearing people. And I remember a brother Chris was here one time and he asked, he had like a poll, like, oh, do you guys know your calling? Do you guys know your gifts? And I remember so many raised their hand, like, I don't know my calling. No one ever prophesied over me. Like, you don't need a prophet to tell you what is your calling. Are you kidding me? The Bible says, Isaiah 61, you are here to raise the dead, cast out demons, preach the gospel to the brokenhearted, set the captives free. That's my calling. Everywhere I go, I pray for someone. If I see someone in pain, I'm going to help them carry their bags, whatever, and I'm going to pray for them. I see people in the gym, this blind guy, he's in the gym. He's yes. you can plant the seed and that's see right. a transformation. Like, it's crazy. So I'm in the gym, and this blind guy is having a hard time. So I walk to the sauna, and then God's talking to me, like, pray for him. You need to pray for him. And that's one of those times where you just want to, I was being human. Like, I didn't hear that. And it's, you need to pray for him. So I'm like, oh, man, I need to go back. I need to pray for him. I'm in the middle of the gym, whatever. But then it's not about me. It ain't about self. Who cares if I pray for someone in the middle of the gym? It ain't about me. It's about the glory of God and what God wants to do with this man and how he wants to use me. So I go back, fight that off. Okay, God, go pray for this guy in the middle of the gym. Everyone's working out right there. Like, they're my tights, man.
Amen.
I think we put so much emphasis on failure and on what the enemy is doing. were made to be. We were made in His image.
Right.
We are ambassadors of the Holy Spirit.
Right. Amen.
Right.
We have everything we need
yes. Amen.
To be molded into Him.
Yes, hallelujah.
Guys, we need to be led by the Spirit, and it is totally possible. We have to remember that Jesus also came in the flesh. He was clothed in the same skin we're clothed in. He baked inside of a woman's womb for 9 months, just like we did, and was born into a worse situation than we were. He was born in a barn, in a little manger. And if you really think about that, like, it was stinky, it was ugly, it was full of cows and like horse poop probably. Like, who knows? Like, he was brought into the world way worse than we do, and we cry about it. We cry about it, and we don't know what to do when issues hit us. And like, I just think every trial I went through, since I have the Word and since I spent time with Him, I commune with Him and I'm one with Him, and He's there to defend me. When issues hit, I dance. What did Daniel do when he was in the furnace? He worshiped the Lord. When I'm in the fire, I'm gonna dance. When there's a lion in front of me that wants to devour me, I'm gonna dance. The books are already there for us, but we need to read them and put them in our life and put them in our situations. We need to relate with the yes. stories in the Bible, with the prophets in the Bible, with the disciples in the Bible. Why aren't we comparing ourselves to them? We think, oh, because they're so great, they were only in the Bible, that was only in those days. God is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
Amen.
Anything He did in the Bible, He can do here. He's yes. did it through my life. He's did it through my life. I would be dead.
Yes.
I would be somewhere probably doped up. All I care about, bro, is getting high. All I wanted to do was just get high and be with my husband and other men. At the same time, that's all I wanted to do. It was so perverse. But to be where I am now in 2 years, and to show love and to go ahead and pray for people and act as Jesus did, I'm not saying I'm Jesus, but heck yeah, I was made to look like Him.
Amen.
I was made in His yeah. image.
Amen.
We need to draw near to Him, and He will draw near to us. Yeah. Jesus lived the life He lived because He communed with Him. He was one with Him, and He was about His Father's business. So that's what I'm about. I'm about my Father's business. It doesn't matter what people are doing and not doing. I'm here for Him. We get so distracted, oh, this person's doing this person's not doing that. Oh, I need to measure up to it, or I'm only as strong as the weakness around me. Like, it makes no sense. It makes no sense. Like, we need to rise up as Christians. And the hurt and the pain and the issues are not here in the church. It's out there in the church. And we need to rise up as Christians. We need to understand who we were made to be, who yes. we were made by, who our identity is, what our identity is, and where we find that at. And we need to go out and fulfill that calling. We want to complain about the politics. We want to complain what's going on in ISIS. We want to complain about every which thing we complain about. But we sit there complaining on Facebook, on Instagram, complaining about it. But why aren't you out there preaching the gospel? You're Christians, and you have the most mightiest, like, weapon and gift in the world, and we're not out there proclaiming.
Uh-huh.
Like, let's take this city back, this nation back, this world back. We are a nation under God. We're a world under God. He's a Lord of hosts, creator of all things. Lord of hosts means creator of all things. So I don't understand why we're complaining and grumbling when we can rise up as Christians and make a difference.
Yes.
And I know so many of us, it starts in our own family. Mm-hmm. So many of us, our family members are hurting. But we're so busy going to church because being a Christian is a church attendance. Being a Christian is not a church attendance. Mm-hmm. Just because you're here and just because you brought your grandchild and your son to church doesn't mean you're a Christian. So just as long as I bring my son to church, then he's a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
A Christian is not a church attendance.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
A Christian is being Christ-like and walking in love.
Amen.
I can go on forever. Just trying to like God, just take me to the next thing. But yeah, so.
Yes, hallelujah.
Amen, Lord. He's good. He's worked amen. In my life yeah. mightily.
Yes, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Let me just leave you. Oh, I'm almost over half an hour. I speak so fast.
great.
I do because I get so passionate, I speak so fast, everything blurts out, and then I'm done.
You're okay.
Okay, so then let me leave you with this.
You're okay. Oops, I'll take your cookies.
So then I just want to leave you with, God died not just so you can forgive your sins. He died so you can live a life of forgiveness. He died to restore you. He died to save which was lost. Whatever's hurting you, whatever the enemy is trying to rob from you, whatever illness, circumstance that you're going through, that's why God died, to restore you back to the garden before sin separated you. He came to save which was lost.
Yes.
You are partakers of the kingdom of Christ. You're partakers of Jesus Christ, of God our Father. He came to redeem you. Guys, get back to that garden. Stand in boldness. Stand in courage. Go out and proclaim the gospel. Lay hands on as many people as you can. Step out in boldness. But it starts with reading your word. Let Him refine you. Let Him get all the corners. Be transformed by Him. Wake up believing. Don't make a rush to Him when your problem hits. Wake up and make a rush and urgency to Jesus Christ. And let the abundance of grace be with you in wholeness. Thank you.
Amen.
And just for a refreshment of what you are made for.